consideration number 3. Why did I add minus 1? Okay, why did I did this data grid and table out and added the new row inside the dim stuff? Okay, the minus 1 here. The idea is to protect the integrity of the ETL, the transformation, and your whole solution. Because what can happen is, and it happened all the time, and I had the customers that it happened to them, we basically joining the dim stuff, or any dimension for that matter, to the fact table. Now, in the fact table, we have a number, an ID, that connects to the stuff. I will take the specific example for the stuff because it will be easier to understand and to grasp. Then I have now I have a fact table. There is a rental. The rental was made by a customer, by stuff number one. The number one is Mike, and Mike do the transformation and do the rent, and this fact getting inside our data warehouse, it goes while it's entering to the dimension of the stuff. It finds the one of Mike and put the number and the name and stuff like that, and it connects with them. Now, 3 years later, this change will grow. Okay, it will be very grow. It will be large, and Mike will be fired from the company, and they will go or fired or will be a manager of another company, and now Mike is not working in the company anymore. So what could happen, and it's happening, although it's very it's unwise to do it, but there is a DBA or people say, okay, this is my Mike, and another 100 customer staff members are not our history and will not work in anymore, so let's delete those rows. So what he does is, actually he goes to the table, the input table, the table of the staff, the source, and he decided to delete those 100 staff members, including Mike. Now when we join the tables with dim stuff and the fact table, our rentals, then we have a problem, because the inner join will get the data, all the history data of Mike to disappear, and then if we try to add the sum of the facts to the history, to what it was like 2 years ago when Mike was the best employee of the month, then we'll have a problem with the data, because it will show the wrong numbers. For that, I made an illustration that you already saw, and this is the case. Okay, we have a table of staff members between 1 and sequence, and staff ID number 5 is here, and so for some reason somebody decided to delete it from the database, for the source table. So what happens now is that when we try to connect those two, it will not connect, because if it's inner join, we will lose the fact table. The fact, actually the rental, the money of the rental, everything that connects to this the specific rental will not show on our BI solution, because somebody deleted the dim. But when you have something like a change in the fact, the ETL will need to recognize it, and when it comes to the staff ID and try to look up, okay, it's another very important step that we will learn, and we will look up to see that actually staff ID that we have in the inner the row that comes into the fact, there is a staff ID in that name. It will be the same staff ID, but if he will not find this 5 here, then he will automatically will overwrite it with the staff ID number minus 1. Okay, that could be also or something else that you can take minus 2, but it's not important. The important thing is that we will have a minus 1 on the fact table, and we have a staff ID number and minus 1, and the name will be NA. Okay, so it's of course it's better that it will be Mike, the name, and the intelligence people, the intelligent DBA that decided to delete rows from the table instead of just putting a status of disabled or fired or something like that, but not delete the row, he decided to delete the row. But we as ETL professionals need to keep the integrity, so we will just make one minus one in the staff ID in the fact, and all the data will be as we needed it before. It will be correct, and this is it.